Hello everyone, I am Meenakshi Chawla from Systems Immunology Lab at National Institute of Immunology. I welcome you all to the India International Science Festival 2021. Today, I'll share with you a few highlights of the research work that we do at NII. So my lab focuses on inflammatory bowel disease, which is a debilitating disease of the intestinal tract, which is characterized by chronic inflammation in the colon. So in IBD, there is a dysregulated immune response, which causes erosion of the protective intestinal barrier and results in persistent inflamed conditions in the colon. This is on NF-kappa B, which is a family of transcription factors that responds to a variety of signals and activate the expression of a number of physiological genes which control the immune response. So NF-kappa B is activated by two pathways, canonical and the non-canonical pathway. And several studies have shown that the canonical NF-kappa B pathway plays a crucial role in triggering the immune response in the gut in response to pathogenic invasions. And once the pathogens are flushed out, the trigger is subsided and the canonical pathway is inhibited. While the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway is responsible for expression of genes involved in lymphokines and lymphoid organogenesis. In IBD-like conditions, the canonical NF-kappa B pathway is hyperactivated, which results in expression of overabundant cytokines that destroy the mucosal barrier of the intestine, and it exposes the intestinal epithelial tissue, which causes uncontrolled inflammation and tissue damage at the site of infection. And the reason for this hyperactivation of the canonical pathway still remains unclear. And recently several studies have shown that both the canonical and the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathways are interrelated at several levels. So we hypothesize that the canonical NF-kappa B pathway could be modulated by the activity of the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway in the gut. So we used colon biopsy samples from IBD patients, and what we saw was, as expected, the canonical NF-kappa B pathway was activated, but also the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway was also activated in those biopsy samples. And to find out that if this elevated non-canonical signaling resulted in enhanced inflammation, we used wild-type mice and mice which lack NF-kappa B2 gene, which is a key component of the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway, and treated them with DSS, which is a chemical reagent that induces IBD-like conditions in mice. So wild-type mice, after treatment with DSS, they died by day 8 or day 9, while the NF-kappa B2 knockout mice, which lacked the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway, showed up to 65% survival. Also, the disease severity in these mice was less than the wild-type mice. So, our study shows that there is a crosstalk between the canonical and the non-canonical NF-kappa B pathway that drives the hyperinflammatory immune response seen in IBD. Thank you.